Hello, I am Michael Collins. I am the course team leader of A-Level Media Studies here at Long Road Sixth Form in Cambridge. And in this video, I just want to go over exactly what A-Level Media Studies is. So we're going to be talking about the course, we're going to be talking about the specification, we'll be answering some questions such as what is the split between coursework and classwork. Also going to be just going over just roughly what topics we'll be covering over the next 2 years, and also what kind of employment opportunities there are as well for students who have completed an A-Level Media Studies course. So first of all, what is Media Studies? Let's take a quick look at that.
Well, let's go into some examples of this right now. So first of all, what is media studies? Well, this might sound slightly obvious, but media studies is the study of media. Media are different forms of communication. It's the plural of medium. And in media studies, we analyse many different forms of media, including TV programmes, radio broadcasts, social media, magazines, blogs, video games, film, and much, much more. We're interested in how audiences use and interpret media and how different groups of people are represented in media. And we're also particularly interested in why this is the case as well. Over the course of the course, we'll be looking at many different debates, many different issues, many different theoretical perspectives. So not only are we going to be studying media and studying how it's made and why it's made, we are also going to be analysing and describing and studying the effects that media has on its audiences as well. So what do we study in media studies? Let's just very, very quickly just go through a list of all the different media forms that we look at. So we start off with advertising and marketing. This is the first unit we look at straight after you complete your initial film project, which you will complete the second that you start at Long Road. After that, we briefly look at the film industry before digging into one of our largest units, which is on magazines. We also look at music videos and newspapers, online social and participatory media, radio, television, video games, and newspapers as well, which I've left off the list, but it's definitely in there somewhere. While we study a wide variety of media, we are also going to be exploring a range of very particular case studies as well in significant detail, which you're going to be using in the exam. And we're going to go into a couple of examples of these later on in this video. So how is media studies actually assessed? Well, it's 70% exam and 30% coursework, which is frankly a really nice split. So the 70% exam part of it is assessed at the end of 2 years. You will sit two exams at the end of the second year, and you'll explore a wide range of media which you have studied in class already. There won't be anything on the exam that you haven't studied in class. There's going to be nothing in there to catch you out, which means that the other third of the course is coursework related. And the way in which we teach coursework at Long Road is you will complete a cross media production that combines video and online production skills. So at the moment, we ask students to create music videos, and we also ask students to create a magazine tie-in, which ties into the music video. So you'll select a song, any song you like, and you will create a music video which goes along with this song. And in order to do so, you will learn and you will master a number of technical skills to allow you to create the very, very best music video possible.
In addition to class-based work, our students also produce a number of practical pieces over the 2 years, the most popular of which is the music video topic. So let's take a look at some examples of student work from the last 2 years. Now, every subject needs its own language, its own framework, and A-level media studies is no different.
So what we're looking at is a 70-30 split between classwork and coursework, which means that roughly over the course of 2 years, roughly one in every three lessons will be coursework-based, will be practical, which means the other two lessons will be based around media studies in its purest form. So there are four things that we like to look at in media studies, and there are four things that you will be asked about in the exam. The first of which is textual analysis. So for the exam and also for your classwork-based work, you will be asked to analyse a variety of different media using a range of specialist language, which will be taught along the course. So, for example, the very first unit you'll be looking at will be the advertising industry, and you'll be looking at adverts a bit like this Jean-Paul Gaultier Le Male advert, and you'll be thinking about target audience, you'll be thinking about representation, all these things, but you'll also be thinking about things like colour, about composition, and about post-production editing techniques, and how they allow this advert to reach its target audiences. Another thing which is absolutely essential to A-level media studies is this idea of representation. So essentially how different groups, places, and issues in our society are represented by a media product. So how does media portray different groups in society? And why do the makers of media use stereotypes? So over the course of the A-level media studies course, we are going to explore these important questions and many more, generally with reference to recent events. Another really, really essential part of the media studies course is actually how media products get made in the first place. And this comes under the umbrella of media industries. So we explore who makes the media and how it's made. We also study how media is marketed and promoted into increasingly different audiences. And this is something which changes completely year on year. And as digital technologies get more and more involved with the creation and production and marketing of media, all these concepts become more and more important. And we look at the differences between different media industries. For example, how a film is made compared to how a video game is made. Finally, we also look at audience, and this is possibly the most important part of media studies of all. And it involves understanding who watches media, why they watch media, and also how audiences can react to media products. And we look at some of the various extreme and exciting ways in which audiences can respond to and can interact with media products, often using things like digitally convergent media, which might involve things like social media and things along those lines.
Next, let's take a very quick look at the kind of stuff that you'll be learning about over the next 2 years.
So what do you actually study in A-level media studies? What are the set texts? What are the products we're going to be looking at? Well, there's way, way too many to go over in any real detail, but let's just go through them all very, very quickly right now. So straight away, when you start the course, you're going to go off and you're going to make a short film. This is going to allow you to get some practical experience. When you come back from doing that, you're going to start off on our first proper unit, which is advertising and marketing, where you compare and contrast three different adverts from three very different eras, all of which will appeal to completely different audiences. When we've finished advertising and marketing, we then look at the film industry, and we will compare a major film with an independent production. Two different films, two very different budgets, and two very, very different audiences as well. After we finish film, we'll look at newspapers. And once more, we're going to be comparing two very different newspapers, a left-wing newspaper and a right-wing newspaper. At this stage in the course, we can start to talk about politics, and we can also start to talk about how the media may manipulate audiences for political and ideological means as well. After newspapers are done, it's time to move on to music videos. And yeah, again, we look at two very different music videos from two very different genres of music. Music videos may come up in the exam, but also this allows us to introduce the coursework topic where you create your own music video. So we're going to look at a variety of different music videos. You're going to analyze them, and then you're going to take your knowledge and understanding as well as your technical skills to create your own music video. Once this is done, and once the second piece of coursework is done, the magazine product, you will study the radio industry. So the text we have to look at is Late Night Woman's Hour. However, we'll be looking at a variety of different radio shows which target different audience. Likewise with video games, we'll be looking at the Assassin's Creed franchise in some detail, but we will also be looking at a number of independent and major video games as well in order to supplement your knowledge. Then we move on to component two, which is the more difficult of the two exams, but only because we look at them in way, way more depth. So first question in that is the TV industry, where we'll look at two very, very different TV shows. Then we'll look at online media. So the different ways in which online media can target audiences. And this is something which is absolutely integral to the media industries today, the ways in which digital technologies are used. We'll look at the idea of audience manipulation. And we will also look at the idea of online media being able to target far more specific audiences than any other form of media can do. Finally, we look at magazines. So two different magazines, two different eras, two completely different audiences. And once more, you'll be comparing and contrasting these two while looking at a number of different debates.
So you've heard everything there is to know about A-level media studies, and now all you need to do is prepare. So here are a number of ways in which you can get ready for the course.
A-level media studies is an A-level, which means it differs quite fundamentally to another subject like media diploma, the practical version of this course, for example. A-levels are traditionally geared for students who may wish to go to university. However, there's absolutely no expectation that you'll do so, and students can make their own choice. So there are a number of careers which A-level media studies can lead you into, and it's worth remembering that you can choose whatever A-levels you want to choose at Longroad, and you can combine them with any other courses that you want to. So while A-level media studies can potentially lead you into any career, thanks to its difficulty and also thanks to its intellectual rigor, some of the careers where it is most applicable to include careers such as journalism, media production, so making films and TV shows, for example, a role in marketing and advertising, a role which involves photography in some way, for example, wedding photography or something along those lines, something to do with teaching or academic work, quite clearly, promotion, which is a role which is increasing more and more, and something along the lines of product design as well. So there's a wide range of careers which A-level media studies would be excellent in preparing you for. However, media studies can also lead to studying a similar subject at university as well. Now, if you choose to study at university, you don't have to select a course, even really what you've studied before, but in some cases it can help. And A-level media studies is perfect if you're thinking about sort of the following courses. For example, studying film or media production. Studying a course like film studies or media studies, well, quite clearly A-level media studies would be absolutely perfect for that. A-level media studies is also a humanity as well, which means it could lead you into many humanities subjects, for example, sociology. A more practical course such as photography would be absolutely fantastic to complete after completing media studies A-level, and it can also lead you into a variety of art and design courses. But this is just the start. If you fancy a course in philosophy or art history or even sciences, then potentially A-level media studies is the right choice for you. Now, if you're still on the fence, do remember that at Longroad, students have access to an experienced careers guidance officer who can give professional advice at any point during your time at Longroad. So it's very, very natural that you might change your mind about what you want to do in the future, or maybe you just don't have a clue. Here's my top tip for how to pick A-levels. Pick the stuff that you genuinely want to do. Pick the subjects that most interest you. Obviously, I genuinely hope that media studies is going to be the most interesting subject for you. So if it seems like the kind of thing that you want to do, then go for it. So what subjects work well with media studies? Quite frankly, any subject. Media studies is a broad discipline. It combines loads and loads of different aspects, including theoretical, analytical, practical, creative, and also talking and verbal skills as well. Therefore, media goes particularly well with any subject which can be selected at Longroad. And in the past, we've had a number of successful students who have combined A-level media studies with courses as diverse as physics, maths, drama, theatre, photography, art, and so on. So it really, really doesn't matter. As long as media studies is the kind of thing that you can get passionate about, then I strongly recommend you join up. So at this stage, hopefully you're excited about joining the course. So what can you do to get ready? Well, the very best media students are enthusiastic. They love the subject and they are what we call media literate. Media literacy is like being literate in terms of books, but in order to become media literate, instead of all, as well as reading lots of books, we would like you to watch many films, TV shows, to play many video games, to listen to as much radio as possible, to read as many newspapers as possible, and to go on as many websites as possible. So basically, we encourage potential students to watch and to read a wide range of media from a variety of different types and sources, countries and formats. It's in the interest of every potential media student to start the year with a range of different examples to draw from. So there we go. That's your carte blanche to go out there and to watch as much stuff as possible. Please do. But probably the best way to get ready is to check out our A-Level Media Studies blog, which you can find at lr-media.blogspot.com. The blog is absolutely chock full of loads and loads of information about A-level media studies and associated courses as well. There are guides on how to use the blog. There is a full-length revision guide, which you can download for free, which I wrote. You can also find loads and loads of different past paper questions. You can find exemplar past papers written by students and teachers. You can find every single last case study that you'll be studying, a full-on glossary of different media studies terms, and loads more. Probably most exciting of all is the Media Focus YouTube channel, which has only recently been started, but has already got tons of videos on it for students who are currently working in lockdown. And this is something I plan to continue afterwards as well. So if you want to get a taste of A-level media studies at Long Row, do check out the blog at lr-media.blogspot.com and check out the link to the Media Focus YouTube channel as well.
I hope this video has answered any questions that you might have had. If you do have any additional questions, please do not hesitate to contact me at mcollins@longroad.ac.uk and I'll get back to you with answers as quickly as possible.